Welcome to This Week with Sheriff Dave Phelan, a weekly program heard on a number of local radio stations throughout Fairfield County and also seen on LSN television. And do appreciate each and every one of you joining us every week, where we share a lot of things going on within the Fairfield County Sheriff's Office. And this week, a regular guest is Lieutenant Tim Vorce. Good to see you, Lieutenant.
Sure. Good seeing you,
as always.
As always.
And always. And my phone's vibrating here, and I can. Always gets my.
Well, certainly, you're a busy guy. A lot of people calling.
Lots going on in the county.
Yes, sir.
And certainly, I know you always got a lot of different things to share with us every time you're on. This is a busy time of the year. We're just coming off summer as we go into the fall, and I think I'm reminded on a morning like this where we still are in our short-sleeve shirts that it's not going to be long before we switch over to long-sleeve shirts.
Yeah, and I think this was our first weekend of fall that we came into summer. We're going into that fall season. Great football weather, cool in the evenings. A lot of these young guys like getting out there in that Friday night football lights and playing football, and it's just a great time of the year. Finishing up that summer programs, working into our fall within the fair coming up and things like that.
Now, at the fair, we have a tent that we've had set up every single year. And this year, as you did last year, we got really kind of a neat display, don't we? A neat car that's been involved in an accident. Tell us about that.
We do. We started this last year. We had a student that was involved in an accident on our way to get ready for prom that evening, and actually she had rolled her car over, was saved by the belt. So it was a really great message that we put out last year with, and she gave some testimony as to, you know, what happened in the crash, how saving her life was wearing her safety belt, which really did a great deal of education for not only her friends and her students at her school, but we were able to take that message across the county to other kids that are young drivers today. Same kind of display. We've got a wrecked car that's going to be in our tent this year with a message from a young man that says, hey, I had my safety belt on. It saved my life. It's important for you to do that today. Wear your belt.
I can remember a number of years ago, my son, and he was actually a young adult, late teens at that time. He's gone on to be a police officer with Columbus. But I can remember him coming home. He didn't have his seatbelt on, and he actually had gotten a ticket for not wearing his seatbelt by the highway patrol, and he was a little upset about it. Like, I got a ticket, and I said, well, you know, you should have your seatbelt on. We started wearing his seatbelt, and it was within the next month or so he was involved in a very bad car accident where the car was totaled. Mm-hmm. And he survived it. He wasn't hurt badly. But had he not been wearing his seatbelt, and I think many times had he not gotten that ticket,
right,
that it may have very well saved his life. Again, the belt, but the ticket was a good reminder, you know, to
buckle up, certainly. And statistics tell us that you're going to have a safer ride when you do buckle up when you're driving.
Absolutely. Now, you are the academy commander.
Yes, sir.
So tell us a little bit about your responsibility out there at school and where you teach and where you're a commander.
Well, I work part-time at Hocking College, as you know, as an academy commander for the police academy. A lot of great things, a lot of young people coming in to be law enforcement officers today. We have a 582-hour academy. It runs, it's part of the curriculum now at Hocking College. Actually, as you're going into your second year at curriculum down there, you're going to be able to become a certified police officer in the state of Ohio. You'll go through the academy towards the end of that in your semester, beginning in January this year. Kids are going to be going into that. We have an academy starting in January this year. So it's going to be really, really great. Very, very excited about it. A lot of the kids are excited about it. So
now, I think a lot of our viewers and listeners may really not completely understand what it takes to be a law enforcement officer in the state of Ohio. What are some of the classes that have to be taken? What are some of the levels of proficiency that they have to reach mm-hmm. as they go through that? And you train for a number of different law enforcement agencies throughout the state of Ohio, right?
Right. Many officers across Ohio actually are involved in training because bringing law enforcement officers into community college, like Columbus State, like Hocking College, like Eastland, there's a lot of things that these officers who are able to work and bring into that school setting.
So most of your instructors are law enforcement personnel?
Current officers. Yeah. Brian Lowe, detective with the Lancaster Police Department. Sergeant Jared Collins helps out with our firearms. Many of these officers bring their experience into that training. So what we look at is helping a young person who wants to get into law enforcement, who wants to be a police officer, begin in a direction of training them from the beginning of going, if they choose to go to Hocking College, if they choose to go to Columbus State, we work with Columbus Police Academy, so that a lot of those instructors are teaching at different areas, and it gives them what's happening today, curriculum, and with the OPATA program too. So, you know, the important things that you still learn in school is math is going to be important because you got to understand the statistics in a crash and how skid marks and various things like that. You got to understand the dynamics of writing a report, how important it is to write a report today on the computer. Young officers are getting into cruisers today, and we're using laptops that have GPS, that have all the information that's available in technology that we didn't have 20 years ago. Even 10 years ago, as you know, has changed dramatically in our county on how we're responding to calls and using computers.
So what would be some of the different classes that a person would take to become a law enforcement officer?
Well, one of the things will be criminalistics, where you're looking at going into a crime lab. You're learning the basics of fingerprinting, how to use those fingerprints. Brian Lowe, detective with the Lancaster Police Department, is one of our criminalistics instructors, and he does a really great job in instructing those how to process a crime scene, how to get fingerprints, how to take that DNA evidence, get it submitted, get some positive results back on those in evidence collection class.
Mm-hmm.
Many different types of classes. We have a physical fitness class where younger officers today are learning the importance of taking care of themselves while they're out there on the job and to be physically fit to meet the needs of the job every day.
Very interesting. Of course, you have firearms.
Firearms.
Driving.
Yes, sir.
Is part of the equation because there is pursuit driving and those type of things.
Yes, you have driving. You have firearms. You have ADAP. You have a lot of different variable things that we're giving.
You certainly have to be familiar with the Ohio Revised Code and
right.
The,
our legal section is a great. We have an attorney that actually comes in and teaches our legal section. So, and I've got a defense attorney that teaches that part of the legal section too. And who better to learn from than a defense attorney on how to deal with some of these situations when you do
or how to testify in court.
Exactly. Some of those simple things.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, very interesting, and I know you've been out there for a few years and do a terrific job. Things going on in the county. There's some things coming up this week.
Yes. Busy time. We're kind of finishing up our festival season. We had the Millersport Sweet Corn Festival. It went very well. Steve Shover from the Millersport Lions Club, great guy to work with. We do a great job. We bring in about 20 officers up there that provide security for that. We have the Lancaster Festival, as you know, earlier in the summer went very well, and we work with the Lancaster Police Department with that. Canal Winchester Violet Festival, and we're kind of concluding that festival season, moving into the fall, into the fair. Got a lot of football games out there. We've got a lot of officers that are working those games. They ask that you be patient. Cars coming out of parking lots,
right.
Busy time of the year. Just be patient with our officers that are out there directing traffic so that they can get you in and out safely.
And certainly we were talking before airtime this Wednesday at Fairfield Medical Center. Becky Edwards and a number of folks from the Family First group will be there, and certainly Adam H. is part of that, where they're going to be talking about the Youth Behavioral Survey. And for our viewers or listeners that may not know what happens here in Fairfield County, and it's kind of unique to Fairfield County. I know there's a number of other counties that do it, but we kind of started that a few years ago with Orman Hall,
yes.
Who was over Adam H. and has kind of continued since. He has gone to work for the state of Ohio. Actually, where we survey, or they survey, students in Fairfield County at the schools, and it's anonymous, but we really get a sense of what's going on as far as the drug usage, as far as cigarettes, as far as a lot of different behaviors. and we kind of learn from that and kind of look at trends, see what's going on. And one thing that I think is absolutely true, and I think sometimes we miss the point on this, that the vast majority of our students in Fairfield County do not use drugs.
Right.
They do not smoke. They do not do these kind of negative things. And so that's really kind of good. And this year there's some, and I don't want to give away some things, but I think there's been some really positive trends. And so by and large, we have a really good group of young people. And unfortunately, sometimes when negative things happen, when somebody gets arrested, when something like that happens, it really takes over the news media. It's in the paper and those kind of things. But I think this survey is going to really be show really realistically what's going on. Still a small percentage. Not that it's not serious. For that small percentage, it is life-changing, especially when you look at the opiate, the heroin, these things that have devastated Fairfield County and other communities throughout the state, and for that matter, throughout the nation.
Right, exactly. And a lot of those things, and Becky does a really great job in presenting that information, getting it to you so you can kind of understand it, decipher it.
That's right.
And figure out what direction we should go as law enforcement in getting the message to these young people of what we want them to know. What decisions are you being faced with today that you need to understand to make a positive change to help you make those decisions?
That's
so
right.
You're not taking that chance of getting in that car, taking that next opiate type drug or whatever may be available. While we're talking about some of these things, one of the things we're offering this weekend, Saturday, September 29th, as you know, we're working with a drug enforcement agency. We're going to be in Pickerington. We have a drug drop off at the Violet Township Trustee's office on Refugee Road and Pickerington Road and Steeman Road up there at the township building. And then we'll be at the Kroger's from 9 to 2 on Hill Road in Pickerington this Saturday.
So if people have drugs in their medicine cabinet they no longer want, if they come across needles, whatever, bring those in. No questions asked.
Right.
Right. They can drop them off. We're going to take care of destroying those.
Yes, we do. We've done several of these throughout the county. We're going to be in the Pickerington area this weekend, so it's a great way to clean out those cabinets where you've had prescription drugs for a period of time. They're not... you can't use them anymore. They're beyond that expiration date, and you want a safe place to dispose of them. That's where you should be.
And historically, when we've done these drop-offs before, it's been amazing how many items that we actually get. Now, just to clarify, this is for pills that you may come across, any kind of drug paraphernalia, those kind of things. This is not drop-off batteries or those kind of things, right?
Right, right. That's a whole different day that we
yeah,
do
yeah,
that.
Yeah, we don't want to get into picking up batteries.
No equipment like that. Any kind of drugs that you have that you want to drop off that you don't feel safe continuing to keep or you want to clear out of your cabinet at home, bring them over and we'll take care of it.
And again, give our viewers and listeners the location.
Yeah, the Violet Township Trustees Building, which is the corner of Steeman Road and Pickerington Road in Pickerington.
Okay.
And at the Kroger's on Hill Road North.
Okay, and certainly hours again?
9 to 2 Saturday.
And certainly we would encourage all of our viewers and listeners to, if they have some things, again, no questions asked.
Right.
You know, you have, and one of the problems is a lot of times old medication, pills that are in the medicine cabinets, in the drawer, or something
just
like that.
Just kind of sit there for a while.
Yeah, and we're saying get rid of those, especially the painkillers and stuff that are so often abused, and many times people break into homes just to steal those items, right?
Right. Opiates are a thing that people are looking for today when they're going in and committing a burglary, so get those out of your home.
Now, we're just about out of time. I know next week you're going to join us again. You're going to be talking about our Community Watch group, maybe talking a little bit about our specials. A lot of things coming in the next few months. The fair, we're going to be part of that.
And holiday we'll season's more coming up here, yes, sir.
Be here before we know. Lieutenant Tim Vorst, do appreciate you being here this week, and certainly almost a co-host. You're here a lot, but you always bring a lot of good things, a lot of updated things of what's going on within Lancaster, Fairfield County, and our community.
Oh, thank you very much, sir.
And certainly to you, the viewers and listeners, appreciate you being here, and the folks here at Fairfield Christian Academy, all the students that help produce and put this program together for us each and every week. We have been on television now several months, and certainly on our radio affiliates for several years, and do appreciate all of the folks that helped put this program together without any cost. And it's certainly a delight to be a part of a community that does so much in a student body that they have here at Fairfield Christian Academy. Well, the clock on the wall says we've got to go. If you're out there driving, be careful. Buckle up. So until next week, same time, same place, this is Dave Phelan. God bless you, and we'll see you right here next week.
Different. Society should aspire to be more like us.
Be part of the first class. Get energized. Get outside.
Hold on, guys. It's gonna get bumpy.
And get moving. Experience the power of physical activity.
Woo!
Join the movement at ActionHeroAlliance.com.